steps. They expound upon it with more than 13. Others have simplified it with fewer steps. There is no one size fits all, but here's what works for me. The conceiving, growing, and birthing of a sermon in 13 steps. And so let's go through them together. It's very practical. Number one, write it down. Choose the text or the theme. Choose the text. Choose the topic. Now, you may choose it, but it also may choose you. That's what we call inspiration. Sometimes Holy Spirit just impresses you. This is what I want you to preach on. This is the verse you need to focus on. This is the subject that needs to be shared in this moment in time. You may choose it. Sometimes it may choose you. But most of the time, it requires sanctified judgment to choose the text or the theme or the subject that's most relevant for the occasion. So where does this sanctified judgment come from that helps us to determine what text, topic, subject is most relevant to share? Three places this sanctified judgment comes from. Number one, your connection with the Lord, of course. God impresses us through His Holy Spirit as we study His Word. And so when we're connected with God, God will give us wisdom. Number two, our connection with the people. As we mix and mingle amongst the people, listening to conversations and connecting with people, we can know what their need is, their trials are, their struggles that they're facing. And when we know the need, then we can point to the supply. So your connection with God, your connection with people. And number three, your connection to the times. Understanding what's happening in the world, the moods of history, the concerns of the modern mind, this will help us to know what is the most relevant thing we can share according to what is happening in the world. It gives us an idea of what topic, text, or theme we should preach on. Now, other ways we can determine what text to choose is based upon the calendar, what's happening throughout the year. The church calendar, even the secular calendar, sometimes there's holidays and anniversaries and memorials and special occasions and historical events. And during that time of year, people are thinking about certain things. And so sometimes, because people are already thinking about it, we can use those events to teach spiritual lessons. Now, we know that during the Christmas season, people are thinking about the birth of Christ. Now, we know that Jesus was not born during that time. We know that there are pagan origins to it, but nonetheless, people are thinking about it. So there's nothing wrong with preaching a sermon about the first coming of Jesus and the greatest gift of all. Let's use it as a time to evangelize. Let's take advantage of that opportunity. During Easter, people are thinking about the resurrection. Well, most people think about Easter eggs and whatnot. And we know that there are pagan origins behind that, but nonetheless, nothing wrong with preaching a message on the resurrection. 4th of July, Independence Day, maybe a sermon on what freedom really looks like. True freedom, spiritual freedom, freedom from sin, amen? We're using events and holidays to be able to help people to see the bigger picture of spiritual things.